Extended approval flows enable you to create approval units that submit a portion of an entity's data for review first, while other data for the entity can be reviewed later, allowing for a phased approval process. You create extended approval flows by creating approval groups and assigning them to approval unit hierarchies. An approval group defines a slice of data for approval. To create approval groups, under the Application cluster, select Approval Groups. I'll create a group for reviewing the income statement and balance sheet accounts. You define a data slice by creating a rule with member selections from one or more dimensions. I'll select Account for anchor dimension, and then add the data source dimension. If a dimension is not included in the rule, all members of the dimension are included in the data slice. I'll click Add Rule, and then select the members to include in the data slice. I want to include all accounts except memo accounts, so for the account dimension, I'll select Add Exclusion, and then select the memo accounts to exclude them. The data source dimension for this business process includes a user-defined data source member named Special Journal Input. I want data for Special Journal Input to be reviewed in Phase 2. I'll include descendants of Total Input and Adjusted, and then add an exclusion for Special Journal Input. Now I'll save and close the Phase 1 Financial Accounts group. I'll repeat the same process to create an approval group named Phase 2 Adjustments that, for data source, includes only the Special Journal's input member, and for accounts, excludes the memo accounts. A system-defined approval group is provided, named Default Approval Group, and includes all members for all dimensions that are not included in one of the user-defined groups. This group will include the memo accounts, since they were excluded from the first two approval groups. You cannot modify or delete the default approval group. Now I'll create an approval unit hierarchy with an extended approval flow. I'll select the Consolidation Bottom-Up template. Under Extended Approval Flow Type, I'll select Approval Group. I want to require that the Phase 1 Financial Accounts data is approved before the Phase 2 Adjustments data, so I'll select Phase Dependency. When you enable Phase Dependency, an approval unit for a later approval group cannot be promoted to a higher location in the promotional path than an approval unit for an earlier approval group. You specify the order for the approval groups when you add them to the approval unit hierarchy. You use the Assign Approval Groups tab to select the approval groups to use with the hierarchy. I'll add the two groups I created. The top-to-bottom order in the list determines which groups are earlier and later for phase dependency. You can use the arrow keys to change the order if needed. Default approval group is included automatically and is always the last group. The default group includes all data that was not included in an earlier approval group. This ensures that when all approval groups for an entity have been approved and locked, all data for the entity is locked. If I need additional approval groups, I can click Add to create a new group. I'll include the North America entity and its children in this approval unit hierarchy. On the Assign Owners page, there's a separate entity hierarchy for each approval group. You can assign separate owners and reviewers for each combination of entity and approval group. When the Copy Owners to Corresponding Approval Group Members option is selected, adding an owner or reviewer to an entity in one approval group automatically copies it to the other approval groups for that entity. I'll add Aruna as owner to North America for Phase 1 financial accounts, and she'll be added automatically to the other groups for North America. For the entities under North America, I want different owners for each phase, so I'll deselect the copy owners option. I'll enter Barry as the owner for the Phase 1 approval units, and Carol as the owner for the Phase 2 units. Default approval group is always the last phase. In our example, it contains the memo accounts. I'll leave the owner of the entities under North America empty for this approval group, so that they inherit Aruna as their owner. Aruna can then approve and lock all the children by approving and locking the parent. I'm finished working on the approval unit, so I'll save it, and then I'll assign it to a scenario year and period. I'll select Actual, FY22, and January. Let's go to the Manage Approvals page and view the approval units. A separate hierarchy is displayed for each approval group. I can start each approval group for an entity separately. I'll start Phase 1 financial accounts for the North America entities. Their status changes to under review, while the other approval groups for North America remain at not started. Approval status is tracked separately for each combination of entity and approval group. Note that if phase dependency was selected for the approval process, you cannot start a later approval group for an entity before an earlier approval group for that entity. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.